Hello, Darnassians. My name is Connor Darnass18, and I have a new video for you. It's an update to my manga collection that I showed you a couple of days ago. And yesterday, February 24th, I actually went to my nearest town where I usually get my manga, and I found some manga that I wanted in my favourite shop, Waterstones. Okay, it's one of my favourite shops. I've got a couple of other shops I like to get manga in, but Waterstones is my main one. And let's just say I spent a fair bit. I don't care. It's my money. And basically, I just saw them and I just had to. And these are all new series, so to speak. And I bought them because why not? But, and I found out that I, out of the collection I showed you the other day, I actually found out I have read over 60%. 60. So that's a considerable amount for me to actually buy some more and keep it going. I mean, if I've read like 40%, I was like, no, I wouldn't buy anything else. But these are my newest editions, and there's one familiar manga artist, author, whatever, that you have probably seen in the previous video. Well, actually, you have seen in the previous video. So here are my newest manga. First up, Alice in the Country of Hearts by Quinn Rose and Soumei Hoshino. Now, I like Alice in Wonderland. It's my favourite fantasy story. Well, one of them. And it's also one of my favourite Disney movies, and this is just a reimagining of it. And as you can see, the White Rabbit has been personified, so that's pretty interesting. Of course, but then again, Japan would do that. And I also like one of my favourite Vocaloid songs, Vocaloids being synthesized singers, so that's singing any language you program them to, because it is like programming in a sense. And one of my favourite Vocaloid songs that I've used in like one of my previous videos was from my first sprite marathon. And it was Hita Bashira, Alice, or Alice of Human Sacrifice. And that was basically about Alice in Wonderland, and that was a reimagining. And from what I've heard, this is a 2-in-1 omnibus, because there's 6 volumes and there's only 3 of these. So it would make sense that they would do that. And I'm looking forward to reading this. I mean, straight off the bat, it looks cute. It looks amazing, and I can't wait to see this Alice's adventures in this mystical place that we love to call Wonderland. And we'll see how that goes. Next, I have Danganronpa, the animation. It's created by Spike Chunsoft because it's based on a video game of the same title. And the manga is by Takashi Tsukimi. And basically, this bear, he's the headmaster of the school called Hope's Peak Academy, and basically he's got one rule: if you want to graduate, kill someone and get away with it. And these students are all in this game to kill. Now, I've seen what happens in the game. I first got introduced to Danganronpa a few years ago. I had no idea what it was about up until I looked it up, because one of my friends was into it. Well, I'm not sure if they still are, but I know what to expect, but I was very intrigued to see it in manga form. There's apparently 4 volumes. I only got the first one because that's what was in Waterstones. So if I do see the other 3, I will probably get them after I've read this and a few more manga that I have in my collection. But I'm excited. It just looks so fantastic to see everything portrayed in manga form. So, yeah. And just yeah, I've seen everything in every game, so, but not everything like me, the main bits. Anyway, next I have Durarara. I know that's quite a mouthful to say, but that's what it's called, Durarara. And this is by 3 mangaka. It is by Ryogo Narita, Suzuhito Yasuta, and Akio Satorigi. Now this is actually, I think these are actually based on light novels. And I have no idea what it's about, but the name just amuses me. Durarara. And it's just something that I just heard about a little bit and wasn't really to read, so I'm just going to see how it goes and see if I like it or not. I could, I mean, I might not, but as a bonus, I found the first three volumes of this manga, and I love volume three. I don't know if you can see that, but there's mosaic shiny hearts on it. I think you can, but gold as well in the second one. But these look absolutely amazing. I mean, like I say, I have no idea what's about, but I'll find out in due time. And if I do like it, I'll probably give the other arcs a shot, because there's apparently a couple of other arcs. And I nearly picked up the Yellow Scars arc, volume 3. So, this is why I didn't, because it was like volume 3 or 2 or something like that. So, and plus, what if it's a sequel to these? And I'm like, I have no idea what's going on. But again, you have no idea what's going on, to be fair, when you start reading a manga. Anyway, next I have Fragments of Horror by, this is the mangaka I was talking about, Junji Ito. It is a collection of 9 short stories by the greatest horror artist and mangaka, in my opinion, from what I've read, Junji Ito. And I like how there's like a Scream parody on the front, and there's just so much to like. I mean, ever since I picked up and read Gyo, Tomie, and Uzumaki earlier this year, I have just been dying to get some more Junji Ito. And then Fragments of Horror was in Waterstones. I was like, yes, I have to get it. It's Junji Ito. I've not been disappointed with any of his works, to be fair. And it's just, even Tomie, even though it was 740 pages long, the suspense just gets real. I mean, you think how, why, what, when, and stuff like that. But I'm excited to read this. Like I say, 9 short stories, all by Junji Ito, who's personally my masterpiece of horror in manga form. So, that's Fragments of Horror. Next I have Goodnight Poon Poon by Inigo Asano. Now, I've seen a few YouTubers have this in their manga collection, and the YouTubers that specialize in manga and stuff, and it looks so cute. I mean, it's about a boy that wants certain things, but what does he get from it? I don't know. I have to read it to find out. And I've seen all 7 volumes in like Forbidden Planet, so if I like this, I may just get them. And it looks so cute. I mean, I don't even know what this bird thing is. I suppose we'll find out in due time when I start reading. Is the boy that they're talking about an average kid? Is he that thing or what? I don't know. Yeah, I am excited to read it, and it looks fascinating. I like the retro style front as well, like yellow and green. It's got like the dotted around part of the bun. But yeah, this is exciting. This is exciting to start reading, I think. But only time will tell. Next, I have Orange by Ichigo Takano. This is something that I looked at briefly, and it's the blurb made it sound very interesting, but I just didn't pick up because I thought it sounded a bit girly. And then I just thought, you know what, it actually sounds fascinating. I read the blurb again. I was like, this actually could be good. And this is apparently the complete collection, because I also have this, which is the second one. However, I found out that it's not actually the complete collection. There's actually been a 6th volume, which is the final volume. These are five volumes. And the 6th volume is actually being released on its own. So I'm going to get that if I like this. And it's, like I say, it seems fascinating. And this is also my first manga that I bought by Seven Seas. And I should also point out that Danganronpa is also the first one I bought from Dark Horse Comics, I believe. But the artwork looks fascinating, if I have to say so. And it just looks so intriguing to read. So I am looking forward to reading this. And like I say, if I do like it, then I'll definitely get the 6th volume, because it came out only a couple of weeks ago, actually. so that's quite intense. But that's orange. And my last one that I got was Ruby by Shiro Miwa. I have never seen Ruby. I've seen clips, okay, but I've never seen an episode. I've not actually watched the series. But I do. I have heard about Monty Oon's tragic passing, and this is actually the newest published manga I have in my collection. This was published in January this year, so just a month ago, and I'm excited to read this. I love Hello Cuckoo Clock. I love the fact that this is just simplistic in a sense. I mean, like I say, I may not have seen this series, but I'm already in love with the character Yang. And she just looks so badass. And I know this is Ruby. So, and I know what Ruby stands for, just so you know. Because I've drawn the logo, I've drawn symbols of the characters like Ruby, Weiss, Yang, Blake, and other characters in the other faction. I cannot remember the collective name for it, but I do like them, and I'm excited to read this. I think this might be the only volume that they have published, but it's exciting to read it. I mean, you just never know what you find in manga form, because I've got, obviously, The Legend of Zelda. I've seen Splatoon as well, so that's pretty interesting. I've never played Splatoon myself, but I'm looking forward to that, to begin that, if I ever pick it up or whatever. But this is Ruby, and it's based on the animation series. I mean, like I said, I've never seen it, but I'm excited for this. And that does it for this video. If you want me to do other manga videos, let me know, and I will probably say, do you want me to do like top 5 of my favourite manga that I've read? Do you want me to do whatever? Just let me know in the comments and give this thing a like and subscribe to me if you haven't done so already, and I will look forward to speaking to you in another video. And like I say, this will be my last manga update video until probably March, because I will get a few manga then, because I pre-ordered some. But I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you later. Bye bye.